Hello, everyone, and welcome to today's webinar. I'm Iris Kolbatsky, Assistant Science Editor for The Scientist, and I will be moderating our discussion. Today, our speakers Andris Abramenkovs will introduce the CellCelector Flex platform, and Mark Lynch will present a novel workflow that simplifies single-cell isolation from a variety of samples for low-input and single-cell genomics. Before we begin, I'd like to thank Sartorius for sponsoring today's webinar. We like our webinars to be interactive. We encourage you to send us your questions or comments at any point, and our speakers will address these during the Q&A session following the presentations. To ask a question, simply click on the Q&A tab and type your query into the question box located on the right side of your screen. Our sponsor has provided us with some helpful resources related to today's webinar, and we've posted these in our handout section on the right side of your screen. You can access and download these documents at any time during the webinar. If you have minimized the Q&A panel, simply click on the blue chat button in the bottom right corner to bring it back. This webinar will be archived on the Scientist website, and we'll email you the link within a couple of days. Please note that you will not be able to download the presentation slides. And with that, let me introduce our speakers. Dr. Andris Abramenkovs is currently a product manager with Sartorius AG, having been with the company since June 2019. This comes after earning a PhD in medical sciences from Uppsala University in Sweden, where he researched DNA damage repair and treatment options. He aspires to continuously develop his skills and expertise in both R&D and scientific projects through problem solving, laboratory experiments, and scientific communication. Our second speaker is Mark Lynch. Over the past 15 years, Mark has held various commercial applications and business development roles across numerous geographies and organizations such as Applied Biosystems, Fluidigm Corporation, and most recently, Genomic Vision. Mark helped establish single-cell biology with key leaders in the field, such as EBI Sanger, Cambridge Institute for Molecular Medicine, CURK, Pasteur Institute, German Cancer Center, Oxford Genomics Center, and other key customer sites across Europe. With BioScribe Genomics, Mark continues to enhance the field of single-cell multi-omics by bringing the BioScribe Genomics solutions for cost-effective and single-cell multi-omics research and translation to the European market. Okay, let's make sure our slides are up and running. Andris and Mark, take it away.
Hello, everyone. My name is Andris Abramenkovs, and I am product manager responsible for CellCelector Flex technology. Today, in the first part of my talk, we will discuss the major features of CellCelector Flex platform and then move to discuss single-cell picking process and applications. So what is CellCelector Flex? It is a fully automated system that can isolate cells and colonies from various settings. We can pick adherent and non-adherent single cells, clones, and colonies, as well as larger structures such as spheroids and organoids from a variety of different medias. CellCelector Flex can achieve up to 100% picking and transfer efficiency. The transfer itself is a gentle process that results in high cell integrity and outgrowth. In the video on the right, you can see CellCelector in action, automatically picking cells from source plate and depositing them in a destination plate. The instrument consists of an inverted microscope equipped with a CCD camera, motorized stage holding the cell culture dish, a high-precision robotic arm, multiple racks for consumables, heated holder for plates and reagents, and sterilization vial. The system is coupled with workstation that controls the system itself and stores experiments. CellCelector Flex is an extremely versatile system that can be configured to any picking needs. When configuring the system, it is possible to choose objectives between 2x to 40x magnification, to allow identification from a large 3D structure to a single cell. Selection of up to 6 different excitation channels enables support for more complex phenotyping and multiplexing applications. Furthermore, exchangeable robotic arm allows to quickly switch between picking modules to extend the application support. Source vessel is placed in a high-precision motorized stage, which permits to isolate single cells in automated and reliable fashion. Once the cells have been moved to destination plate, this plate can be heated or cooled based on the needs. For example, for omics experiments, sample cooling during extraction is crucial, as keeping DNA, RNA, and protein cooled ensures better stability of these structures. When looking closer at the picking modules, the system can be equipped with semi-solid picking module that takes advantage of disposable tips, adherent colony picking module that is using reusable stainless steel tips, and a single cell picking module that is using glass capillaries and is the most versatile picking module. Once the picking module is installed in the system, it is automatically recognized and all corresponding picking protocols are loaded within the software. When it comes to picking and depositing of cells, CellCelector Flex allows to pick almost from anything to anything. As a source vessel, we can use nanowell arrays, cell culture microplates with clear flat bottoms, microscope slides, petri dishes, and even custom plates. We can deposit the material in cell culture microplates, multiwell slides, petri dishes, and even PCR tubes, strips, or plates. With extended support of different vessels, we can extract cells from cell culture and tissue samples, like tissue sections and everything in between. Using our cooling deck tray, we can make sure the destination vessels are always cooled, making sure that the extracted material is protected from degradation. The CellCelector is all in one solution that guides users through steps of scanning, object detection, review, and transfer of cells. After scanning of a plate, the object can be automatically detected according to user-defined parameters. Then, selected objects can be further filtered, sorted, and transferred to a destination plate. During the experiment, overview images, numerical data of all cells, and QC images are automatically saved in the database and can be exported for reporting. All of the objects identified in analysis step has a unique ID assigned throughout the experiment and can be easily traced. Before and after picking images, ensure that you have picked the cells of interest and nothing more, nothing less. Optionally, automatic assessment of picking success is also available. In the second part of the talk today, I will focus on single cell applications and isolation. So why single cell analysis is important? It allows us to identify cell heterogeneity within tissues by allowing to characterize each single cell based on their epigenetic modifications, genetic properties, gene expression status, and metabolic state. With traditional bulk analyses, this heterogeneity might go unnoticed, especially if some subpopulations are low in numbers. In disease research, single cell analyses can help to separate diseased cells and help to identify key genes and pathways driving disease progression. Further, these results can be used to discover new drugs and biomarkers. Alternatively, information from single cell analyses can help to identify molecular signatures that are unique to patients' disease. This can then be taken further to develop tailored treatments. In developmental biology, single cell analyses can help to understand how different cells are arising during development and how they are differentiating into specialized cells. Now we're going to focus more on the single cell picking on CellCelector. CellCelector's single cell picking module is a versatile tool that can support many applications, starting from purification of single cells for omics experiments to isolation of small tumoroids and organoids. Please note that there are more applications supported than listed here. So how do we achieve the large application support with CellCelector? The answer lies within hardware capabilities of our single cell picking module, which can hold wide variety of glass capillary diameters that allow to pick single cells, clusters, and even small organoids or tumoroids. Also, high precision aspiration ensures gentle cell retrieval and preserves cell integrity. The tight control of aspiration volume allows us to pick up a single cell without disturbing neighboring cells. Moreover, pickup of cells from different plate formats can be calibrated in software by using extremely precise touch sensor inbuilt in robotic arm. When using a single cell picking module, it is possible to take advantage of nanowell arrays that support adherent and suspension cell isolation and culturing. With this module, single cell retrieval takes about 25 seconds, while pooling of single cells takes about 10 seconds per cell. CellCelector supports many different single cell capture formats. Cells can be extracted from standard plastic plates or dishes. For suspension cells here, the cells need to be immobilized on the surface of a plate to restrict the cell movement during scanning and picking. As an alternative, cells can be also picked from magnet pick slides that are using magnetic field to align the beads and keep the cells in their position for screening, detection, and picking. In this approach, cells have to be pre-processed using positive immunomagnetic enrichment methods. Lastly, single cells can be isolated using our nanowell plates that can capture one cell per well. And once all of the cells of interest are detected, they can be easily retrieved. Here, we will be looking at some of the examples of single cell isolation from standard plastic surfaces. Even highly adherent endothelial cells are possible to be isolated. Please note that in this example, we used adherent colony picking tool with stainless steel tips. Adherent cells can also be extracted using single cell picking tool as shown here with example of HeLa cells. You will quickly notice that these two cells are very closely located, even though we were able to retrieve one of these cells without disturbing the other, just illustrating the extreme precision what is possible with CellCelector Flex system. When it comes to non-adherent cells, the isolation process is more challenging because without any coatings like poly-L ornithine or poly-L lysine, the cells can shift focal planes and move around during scanning and retrieval process. When we are using coatings to immobilize the cells on the surface of the plastic, we need to perform additional tests to make sure that the cell biology is not affected by the coating itself. In the example here of non-adherent cell picking, you will see a mouse CD4 positive T cells and HT29 cell isolation. The positive immunomagnetic enrichment starts with a heterogeneous sample in solution. The specific population of cells are labeled with antibodies and magnetic particles. Using magnet, the successfully labeled cells are retained in the solution while negative cell population is washed away. Then cells are stained for further characterization using antibody cocktail, and afterwards the cells are captured on our magnet pick slide and transferred to CellCelector for scanning, analysis, and isolation. Single cells then can be analyzed based on their DNA, RNA, and protein contents. Usually this kind of workflow is used for extracting rare cell populations, like, for example, circulating tumor cells. In the example here, we have stained circulating tumor cells with DAPI and two different cell surface markers, from which one has to be positive and the other one has to be negative for cells to be classified as a circulating tumor cell. Once all circulating tumor cells have been identified, the cells can be isolated and sequenced. Overall, isolation of cells using positive immunomagnetic enrichment is a reliable method for isolation of single cells when paired with our magnet pick slides. However, it is the staining procedure with beads and antibodies that is time-consuming and costly. As we discussed before, single-cell isolation can be a tricky process, especially for cells in suspension, as we need to ensure that cells are not moving around during imaging and picking. This is where our nanowell plates come into play, as they allow to restrict single cells to each nanowell. These nanowell arrays are available in plate and slide format, and the size for each individual nanowell ranges between 25 microns to 200 microns. Nanowells with smaller wells can be used to isolate single cells, where larger nanowells can be used to expand and establish new cell lines. Nanowell plates come also in different shapes and are available in square, hexagonal, and elongated shape. Based on the format, it is also possible to select up to 200,000 nanowells per well. Plating cells in a nanowell plate is easy and takes only 5 minutes, as we add cells in the media to well and spin them down using centrifuge or let them sediment. These plates support high throughput experiments and save time and money in the process. And mainly that's achieved by replacing stacks of 96 and 384 well plates. In this example, we will be looking at a single well from U25 slide that contains 200,000 nanowells for each individual well. The slide here is scanned with 10x objective and it is acquired in bright field channel. All of the individually acquired images are stitched to create an overview image of whole well. Using high quality imaging platform, we can easily identify cells when zooming in on each individual nanowell. Even with a 10x objective, we can also see individual beads. After completion of scan, we can move forward to analysis. User-friendly analysis tab allows us to quickly generate analysis for each individual channel. We can select multitude of different analysis parameters for characterization of your cells. For example, size, shape, sphericity, fluorescence intensity, and many more. Each measurement comes with a description so that we can easily understand what each number really means. It also helps when additional filtering and processing is needed. Once the analysis definition is created, we can save it and use it for our next experiment. When analysis is completed, each identified cell or object is assigned a unique ID for traceability throughout the experiment. This makes sure that no cell gets lost during the process. Then, in the next step, we move to the filtering, and it's possible to filter all cells based on the parameters selected in analysis. For example, like morphological properties and fluorescence marker positivity or negativity, which allows us to narrow down to identify the objects of interest. All filtered objects then are listed in a gallery view where we can inspect them visually. From the gallery view, we can also manually deselect objects to remove them from the pick list. Now it's time to move to picking procedure, so let's talk about it in more detail. Before picking cells, we can pre-fill capillaries with buffer solution from buffer station or destination plate. Then we can pick single cells and deposit them in destination plate. After finishing the picking procedure, the capillary can be sterilized as needed. This workflow is reiterated until all of your cells of interest have been transferred. The workflow here is just an example, as various routines can be programmed to ensure the capillary tip is free of carryover material from sample to sample or single cell isolation to single cell isolation. In the video here, you will see a single cell picking process in real time, and you can monitor this process at any given time during cell picking. You will also notice in this video that some of the frames will be flickering. This is the time when we are actually acquiring images. So you will notice that we acquire images at the beginning of the picking procedure and then at the very end. So once the picking has been successfully completed, we move to the next cell, acquire image, take up the cell, and then acquire image again. This ensures that we have a proper documentation throughout the whole experiment. In summary, CellCelector is a truly versatile system that supports many different cell isolation setups. It also makes cell isolation easy, preserves cell integrity during the cell picking process, and assures proper documentation. CellCelector is a custom configured to your picking needs, and please do not hesitate to reach out to us if you have any further questions. With that, I would like to thank you for tuning in and looking forward to your questions in Q&A session. Now that we have talked about how to quickly and easily identify, select, and retrieve a single cell with the CellCelector platform, I'll hand over to Mark, who can take us through how these single cells can be used for low-input single-cell genomics.
Thank you. Today, I will introduce to you BioScribe Genomics' unbiased whole genome and whole transcriptome chemistries for deep characterization of single cells important in cancer heterogeneity studies. There are two chemistries to introduce to you in this webinar. The first, Resolve DNA. Resolve DNA provides unprecedented genomic coverage and uniformity for calling of single nucleotide variation, copy number variation, insertions and deletions, and somatic mutations. The second, and perhaps most important in the era of multi-omic analysis, is ResolveOme. ResolveOme takes the same Resolve DNA chemistry and adds in full-length cDNA analysis. Today, we will therefore inform you on technology for whole genome and whole transcriptome analysis from the same single cell. Let's start with Resolve DNA. Resolve DNA is the core of our technology at BioScribe Genomics. Resolve DNA is powered by a method known as PTA, Primary Template-Directed Amplification. Resolve DNA with PTA methodology increases the fraction of the genome covered, provides much higher uniformity of the genome, and a much better allelic balance than any other method of whole genome amplification on the market. The first way in which Resolve DNA does this is by using multiple random primers. These are shown on the schematic on the right-hand side of the slide. These multiple random primers also have terminator molecules added to them. You can see these in purple, also in the schematic on the right-hand side of the slide. These terminator molecules terminate the random primers after a short period of extension, normally between 250 and 1500 bases. This termination then enables the extension of the next random primer and termination of that next random primer. And it continues doing that until the reaction is complete. What this creates are short fragments, and these short fragments do not reamplify the previous fragment. Instead, that primary template is reprimed for what we call additional favored amplification. In other words, it's directed back to the original DNA template, creating this favored amplification. The random primers, the terminators, and the favored amplification ends up creating a short fragment of DNA that is around 500,000-fold amplified. And because we use a quasi-linear-based amplification protocol, we generate excellent uniformity, coverage, and reproducibility. And so these 500,000-fold amplified DNA products are covering more than 97% of the genome. This is very important in characterizing tumor heterogeneity. The standard workflow for resolved DNA looks a little bit like this. Cells are sorted into a microwell plate, such as a 96 or a 384 well plate. This can be achieved using flow cytometry, or it can be achieved using the cell selector system from Sartorius. Once those cells are in those 96 or 384 well plates, there are two simple steps that the resolved DNA chemistry takes care of. This is shown in dark blue on the right-hand side of the slide. The first is the cell lysis step, and the second is the whole genome amplification step. These two critical steps take just 30 minutes hands-on time. And once it's complete, the BioScribe Genomics library preparation workflow generates libraries for processing on next-generation sequencing platforms. And once the data is complete, the data can be analyzed using the BioScribe Genomics Base Jumper Analysis Suite. In summary, the workflow for resolved DNA is end-to-end, with the exception of the sequencing piece in the middle. An example of how our resolved DNA chemistry is used is in the field of cancer heterogeneity. And an example of this of particular importance is in something called ductal carcinoma in situ, or DCIS. DCIS is a neoplastic proliferation of ductal epithelial cells that can be a precursor to invasive breast cancer. On the schematic in the slide, you can see how this develops from normal into hyperplasia, into atypical hyperplasia, and then eventually into ductal carcinoma in situ, or DCIS. A fundamental research mission is to understand the influence of the stromal microenvironment and cell and genomic events that drive this transition to invasion. Using the resolved DNA chemistry, the comparison between the cell lines, in this case GM12878 cells, and ductal carcinoma in situ cells is very, very close. We are recovering with resolved DNA more than 95% of the genome in most single cells. And importantly, this coverage of uniformity is happening in primary sample as well as cell line. Looking at the copy number variation plot and the CNV plots on the right-hand side of the slide, you can see that with normal, we have a kind of normal CNV plot with no aneuploidy. The chromosome structure was found to be intact. When we look at cell 1, cell 2, cell 3, and cell 4, shown as B, C, D, and E, you can see the differences in the copy number variation plots. The tumor 1 sample, labeled B, looks pretty normal. But when we get to tumor 2 and tumor 3, we start to see some of the deletion events in chromosome 13, 16, and 17 that are known to be associated with breast cancer. And when we get to tumor 4, labeled as E, we actually identify other deletion events with the resolved DNA chemistry in chromosome 11 that were not expected to be seen. And as part of our collaboration in this, we were identifying new and unexpected actionable genomic information, meaning that in this particular individual, this cell and these cells enabled a change in the treatment regime of that particular subject. Resolved DNA is therefore an isothermal quasi-linear method that delivers unbiased, uniform allelic balance, coverage, and reproducibility to deliver a complete and comprehensive view of the single-cell genome. The chemistry is compatible with upfront cell selection and cell sorting methodologies, offering flexibility. And it's a simple and refined workflow with no expensive single-cell instrumentation needed. And it's scalable. Our chemistry can be run in 96 or 384-well formats. The second chemistry to introduce to you today is ResolveOhm. ResolveOhm enables comprehensive single-cell multi-omic analysis. Many of you will ask the question, why study the genome and the transcriptome from the same single cell? The reason is that there is an interplay between the RNA and the DNA, and that information helps the diagnosis and understanding of pathogenesis and cancer susceptibility. So if one is studying tumor heterogeneity and trying to correlate heterogeneity to pathogenesis, single-cell multi-omic analysis is the only way to do it. A publication in 2022 from Horton et al. Actually stated that DNA sequencing alone is limited in its detection and classification of mRNA splicing variants, particularly those located far from the coding sequences. As a result, ResolveOhm is the only method in the single-cell field that provides heterogeneity, a correlation to pathogenesis, and a full characterization of single cells. The schematic in this slide actually shows that even droplet-based methodologies cannot deliver the multi-omic analysis features in the same way that ResolveOhm can. And in fact, ResolveOhm from Bioscribe Genomics provides more than threefold data per single cell than droplet-based methods. The workflow is very similar to a ResolveDNA workflow that we covered earlier in the presentation. The key differences, really, is the lysis. The cells are collected in the same way, such as using flow cytometry or by using the cell selector system in 96 or 384-well plates. And once those cells are collected, we perform a cytosolic lysis to permit the first generation and first strand cDNA synthesis to take place. Once that's complete, in the same well, the ResolveOhm chemistry then performs a nuclear lysis to disrupt the nuclear membrane to enable the amplification of the genome. And so all of this is taking place in the one well. The cell is not split at all. Once we've amplified our whole genome, it is at that point during the library preparation that the cDNA arm of ResolveOhm and the genomic DNA arm of ResolveOhm is split. And each of these, shown on the right and shown on the left, undergo parallel library preparation using the ResolveOhm library preparation kit. Sequencing is then performed on sequencing platforms, and data analysis is performed using the base jumper solution from Bioscribe Genomics. The transcript data that's generated from ResolveOhm is shown on the left-hand side. The first thing to note in this column is that the full-length detection of transcriptome features is only possible because ResolveOhm is using a full-length cDNA analysis, including the 5' and the 3' UTR. So we overcome the bias observed by droplet and end counting methods. The second thing to note is that we are detecting around 7,000 genes per single cell. 7,000 genes per single cell. It means that we're detecting a lot more information than is possible using droplet-based methods. And we're able to analyze splice variants, fusion genes, and transductions. It's also important to note that we do not get any genomic contamination in this workflow. The library preparation and the sequencing of the genomic arm, as well as the mRNA arm, are absolutely separate, and there's no crossover between the two. ResolveOme is the multi-omic solution for detecting DNA and RNA from the same single cell. And because this era of multi-omics is so important, our plan is to start to include targeted protein analysis within the ResolveOme chemistry. More information can be found on our bioarchive paper. To summarize the ResolveOme, it's a broad single-cell multi-omic analysis solution that combines the resolved DNA primary template-directed amplification with full transcript reverse transcription. It's comprehensive in its depth of information, with more than 90% of the genome and full-length mRNA coverage revealing the consequences of genomic variation on gene expression and transcript structure. And it's an accurate and unified workflow that is simple and easy to use, interrogating DNA and RNA without splitting source material or interpreting across multiple data sets. It's scalable and readily available with 96 well plate formats without the need for expensive droplet instrumentation.
Thank you for your time and attention today. We are happy to have been able to share with you this integrated workflow enabling spatial single-cell genomics. You can find the full application note on our website, but we also will make sure to share this on this platform for all attendees. And now, we're happy to take your questions.
Thank you very much, Andris and Mark. As a reminder to the audience, you can submit your questions at any point during the webinar. The audience has already submitted several questions, so let's get to those. First question for Mark is about the shape of the... Let's start with Andris. The shape of the chips. Why were they designed the way they were? Could you comment on that, please?
So yeah, for specifically that nanowell application, we have designed chips to have these circular pattern with the small wings. The reason for it is because we can fit one single cell in this shape much better. So that essentially makes sure that we don't fit two different cells. If it's square shaped, it's much easier to fit, for example, multiple cells in the same well. And also when we go down with the capillary to pick up the single cell, these wing-shaped parts also allows much easier flow of the liquids within vicinity and thus facilitates the pickup of the cell.
Thank you. And can you also talk about the cell selector nanowell arrays and how they're used?
So nanowell arrays themselves come in a very, very different shape, starting from a small 25 micrometer diameter up to 200 micrometers. So here we have possibilities to identify single cells. We can also look at potential growth of the cells, like, for example, in cell line development applications, we can expand one single cell into a larger colony and then easily transfer that while still assuring the monoclonality of the day zero.
Thank you. And another question about the cell selector. What is the final volume? And the audience member is asking, can I control it to a very low volume?
Absolutely. So we can actually control the pickup very, very easily. So we are using a small microvalve system that allows you essentially to pick up starting from 1 nanoliter to 10 microliters. So the increments essentially are by 1 nanoliter at a time. So in summary, that gives you quite a good control of the pickup parameters for each individual cell type that's required.
Thank you. And one additional question before we switch gears to Mark. What are some of the other applications for cell selector?
So cell selector itself is quite a flexible system. Besides single cell applications, we can also isolate clones in the media or also adherent clones, like for example, stem cell colonies. We can also isolate clones from the solid media, which is good for the hematopoietic expansions. We can also do a 3D applications like isolation of tumoroids, organoids, or embryonic bodies. So we have quite large versatility, starting from pickup of 20 micrometer diameter glass capillaries, ending up to 1.2 millimeter of plastic tips. So there is a quite large variety of the objects that we can pick up.
Okay, thank you. And Mark, our first question for you is, how does Resolve OME analysis, how is it performed? Is it similar to 10x genomics?
Yeah, so the Resolve OME analysis, which is the multi-omic analysis solution from BioScribe Genomics, is analyzed using our base jumper analysis platform, which is included for access, is included when a user acquires the Resolve OME kit. So it's an end-to-end solution in terms of chemistry and analysis.
Thank you. And a follow-up question, what is the throughput for Resolvome?
Yeah, so the Resolvome chemistry is sold as a kit per sample. So it gets sold with enough for 96 samples or 96 cells per kit. And our customers typically run a few thousand cells per study.
Thank you. And an additional question about Resolvome. In the WGA step, is the cDNA amplified? And if not, why not? Is it related to the template length?
Yeah, it's a good question. And I think there was another question on this same theme from Anna Egan. So just to touch upon both questions, the first was really related to the separation of the amplified DNA from the amplified cDNA. So essentially, as we showed in the schematic, the cDNA part is a kind of biotin-labeled cDNA pool. And so that then is available for cryptdavidin purification. And so we do that to pull out the cDNA from the genomic DNA. And in terms of the second part of the question, is the cDNA amplified? In the schematic, we showed that after we separate that cDNA out, it does perform a brief amplification step.
Thank you. And one question that just came up now, what is the read depth to achieve 7K genes per cell?
Yeah, so that's a good question related to the sequencing metrics. And so we generally perform two steps of analysis when it comes to that. The first is what we would call a kind of low pass, which would be a kind of 10 to 20X. And then to look at much more information, you would go at about 30X.
Thank you. And another question for you, Mark. Is Resolve DNA compatible with existing NGS instrumentation? Or can Resolve OME be used for studying pathway analysis involving... Can Resolve OME be used for studying pathway analysis involving gene silencing?
So the short answer to the second part of that question is yes. The Resolve DNA chemistry is compatible with next generation sequencing platforms like Illumina. For the longer read next generation sequencing platforms, we can talk about that offline, but the kind of kitted solution for Resolve DNA works with the kind of standard NGS platforms.
And another question, does Resolvome capture RNA in the nucleus?
Currently not. The way in which we do the lysis steps for Resolvome, where we do a kind of cytosolic lysis to start with, followed by a nuclear lysis, prohibits us at this time from being able to do that. But it is something that's part of our development roadmap to have a nuclear protocol for Resolvome.
Thank you. And can you comment, please, before we wrap up, about time savings and the CellCelector workflow? What is the workflow before CellCelector look like in comparison to CellCelector?
Is that aimed at me or is that aimed at Andreas?
We can have Andreas answer that. And then maybe you can comment about the instrumentation for a different question.
So in general, there is some major time savings because all of the systems here are automated. So this is one solution that can essentially sometimes improve the discovery or workflow, and essentially up to 5 weeks sometimes. And the question really is depending on your applications. So if you do a single cell applications, you don't have to pick manually or use alternative methodology to segment the cells or isolate them. You can easily just retrieve what you're looking at. And when we look at 96-12 plate isolation, we can do that approximately in half an hour, right? So that is something that is much more complicated with other technology. So in the end of the day, it really depends from your workflow. But how about your marks?
Yeah, I would say similar to what you've said, Andreas. And with regards to linking the cell selector and the bioscribed genomics chemistry, the idea behind this is that we want our chemistry to be compatible with instrumentation like the cell selector system, where you can actually really identify and select the cells of interest and then use very deep characterization chemistry like the Resolve DNA and the Resolve AIM to really characterize the tumor cells that you're trying to study.
Perfect. Thank you. And a question about the cell selector, just to wrap up, which additional tests is needed to check the integrity of the cells during isolation or suspension?
So in principle, there's you can do whatever test you would like to perform. Either you can do a staining, for example, to assess the viability. There's also some applications when you isolate the single cell and then expand them. So in that case, you would just monitor the cell growth over a period of time to see how well it is. But in general, the retrieval of cell selector is very, very gentle. So we would expect almost like 95% of the viability based on the application that you're looking at. So in principle, to wrap it up, I would say if you're interested in just looking at the integrity afterwards, you can just perform viability staining afterwards.
Okay, thank you so much, Andris and Mark, for your discussion. We really appreciate you joining us here today. If anyone has any further questions, please consider reaching out to the speakers directly. Their contact information will be shown on the screen. As a reminder, the webinar will be archived on the Scientist website, and you will receive an email notifying you when the on-demand webinar is available. Make sure to follow the Scientist on social media for updates on future webinars. And I'd like to thank everyone who took the time to join us here today, particularly those of you who shared your questions and comments. On behalf of the scientists, I'd also like to thank our speakers again, Andris Abramenkovs and Mark Lynch, as well as our sponsor, Sartorius. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye.